past active work, I see words about the attachment with Webster architecture, because we tend to build houses with ceilings taller than ourselves, with space above to reach, to jump, and to jump while reaching. We know a little something about this whether we know it or not. We enact this knowledge with rooms with upward-facing bristles. Ideally, the spider will build their web at the center of the passage through which insects make their thoroughfare, however narrow, perhaps an inch square of area in the corner of what we might otherwise call a hallway, preferencing the corners, and ideally for many this thoroughfare is not our house. The capacity for insects to inform us of the health of our ecosystem irregardless, or smart, or safe, insects have been condemned as a sign of ill health. And so in ideal circumstances we find spiders, big fat spiders, stretched full width between trees, canopied in a row, able to be hatched through with your face and able to ricochet the momentous human cannonball, where they are subject only to the wind and the rain and of these, only the fears. What we know of spiders is out of touch with what we feel about spiders. The most proliferated are cellar spiders, and it is these you find in the corners of your lounge room informing you of nothing but the dust. They are otherwise known as daddy long legs, but so are the pileonies and the pileonies. Even more marvelous than their names, are vegetarian, like male mosquitoes, and all belly, unlike the insect, segmented into the head, thorax and abdomen. In Australia there is also a winged insect called the daddy long legs, so let's call them cellar spiders though they can't be found elsewhere than cellars. These are the most poisonous spiders in the world, and also the least dangerous, for the reason that their fangs have less depth than human skin and their necrotic, disintegrating spit that liquidates the innards of a fly, our most hated enemy, cannot penetrate our bloodstream. It might be fun to measure their fangs along the scale of a nerve cell. These spiders build the webs we call cobwebs, a gentle layer of silk over anything that doesn't move. Where there is movement, where spaces are large enough to accommodate us, cellar spiders preference corners, and will gladly inform us that we have encroached into their corner unawares by oscillating their body at speeds measured on the scale of the hummingbird or plucked guitar string, ideal for the threatening limitations of peripheral vision. Implying their namesake, the webs of cellar spiders stretch throughout the expanse of spaces less frequently occupied, threads of silk mat in a design beyond my intelligence, and not without memory. Generations of cellar spiders will reuse their family's webs and in this way resemble the memory of a stone under a drip of water. Older webs, fortified by dust and the tracks of spiderlings who, tagging burst in impossible numbers the way clowns exit cars in impossible numbers or more recently pulpy fens at dog houses in impossible numbers, viewed like the others cast a line of silk into the air allowing the wind to carry them as the wind carries dandelion seeds. Solids in the way that clay is a solid or a forest is a solid or have impossible scales of wardrobe that can only be budged by thinning yourself in the space between it and the wall and the palms of your feet against the wall, push with the palm of your back and your bum on the ground or ice is a solid and one over another the way when you make a graph of your DH of X and Y axis at right angles and label 1 to 100 of the X and 1 to 1. 100 along the Y drawing a line with a ruler between 100 and 1, and 99 and 2 and 98 and 3 and 97 and 4 and 96 and 5 and 95 and 6 and 94 and 7 and 93 and 8 and 92 and 9 and 90 and 1 blotto here on the wall. Yes, those 102 lines create the illusion of a curve or when you anchor 100 nails into the chipboard 1 centimeter apart and connect the string between nails you create the illusion of a curve or the way, if you move each fence post on the perimeter running parallel the road closer to the road 1 meter that's x kilos of line more per meter per crop, incremental, and I do it at night, after harvest so I can lay the chaff over the old perimeter but then the sun gods would get me for being greedy you know. Doing exactly as they do in Dan Brown's Angels and Demons the movie, when Tom Hanks is trying to break the bulletproof glass to get oxygen into the room and when he finally gives up having given it everything he's got, what happens next is always God. Over many years the spiders